Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. What we're looking at in this video is a frequency distribution table and the graph that would go with it. So this is a histogram. It uses quantitative data. And what we have at the bottom are what we call the classes. Now over here, this person's used this, called these the number of cappuccinos. But those are actually the classes. And that means we have a class from 0 to 3, from 4 to 7, from 8 to 11, and so forth. And then for each class, we have a frequency. So you can see from 0 to 3, the frequency was 2. And that means when we draw the histogram, that's going to go up to 2. So along the y-axis is the frequency, or how often people fell into that category. And then we have 4 to 7, which has 3, which is a little more, and the highest number was 8 to 11, and then it drops off again. Now notice if we subtract the first number in each class from the next highest one, so 4 minus 0 is 4, 8 minus 4 is 4, 12 minus 8 is 4, 16 minus 12 is 4, that's the class width. So the class width here is 4 because we can subtract those starting numbers and find out that that's 4, and we need to make sure that our class widths are equally spaced when we're making these histograms. So if you were asked what was the frequency of the class that contained the number 13? You would say, well, 13 is in this class, and it went up to 3. So then you would just answer 3. So you can look at the histogram and answer questions like that. And over here, we can see what the number is also without looking at the histogram. But I think in some of the problems, you might have not the table, but just the histogram available. All right, have a great day.